Candace talked about results, and I saw the results right away in a close friend. But the most important results, as Candace always points out, is how we relate with our own experience. And that's where the deal was sealed. Once I started taking the short moment practice and using the rest of the mainstays, it was all over in terms of where I knew where I wanted to be. I saw that all these abstract and intellectual understandings I had about impermanence and emptiness and no self, it was all intellectual understanding, but the balanced view of practice really made it real for me. And that's really what I see as education in the nature of mind, of knowing how to work skillfully, competently, for the benefit of all, with the constant flow of dynamic energy that we all face. And we can call it anything, phenomena, data, just the constant activity that is life. Emptiness is very alive. There's so much activity that we all face. And if we take ourselves to be a separate someone trying to deal with all of that, you can see the tension building. And actually, that tension building is an incredibly wonderful gift. And that's how I came to see anxiety, actually. Anxiety was such a beautiful gift, because if you really pay attention, it stops you in your tracks and you realize something's got to give here. There's got to be a release somewhere. And that release finally came in the skillful application of the instructions that I was given, instead of trying to think my way through everything and trying to figure out these data streams by either somatic activities like yoga, breathing, or medical interventions or herbal interventions, herbs and so on. I never ended up taking medication, but I could see that path down the road if I were to continue that way. So anyways, it's been a sheer joy to be a part of this community for 6+ years and to grow closer and closer with Candace. I'm grateful for second chances. I met Candace in 2006 and was not attracted to Candace, even though the message hadn't changed. It was me. I thought I knew what I was doing. I thought I could use meditative practices to completely open up, but it was meditative practices based on a separate self and embellishing a separate self more. And that leads to obvious tension and confusion. And that's what happened. So finally, accepting the invitation to the introduction to open intelligence and seeing the profound wisdom in the teachings and getting closer and closer to our dear teacher. She's the only person in my life that has ever said, "I will never let you down." My parents never said that. No one has ever said that to me, actually. But given the 6+ years of really steeping in this environment, I can honestly say that, I certainly believe Candace, because it's been my experience. I know I won't be let down by the Four Mainstays, because these have a lineage way beyond Candace as well. These go back. These are timeless wisdom teachings that have no beginning and no end. So complete gratitude everywhere. And I'm also so impressed with the young people. Anybody who gets it early on is an incredibly fortunate being. You don't have to wait till you're 52 to get whacked by reification and realize that staying open and continuing to open is where it's at. So, thank you.